So what is TypeScript? At a super high level, TypeScript is JavaScript with static type checking. What that really means is that you no longer have to write JavaScript code purely based on faith and good guesses that the variables and objects you're using are what you think they are. TypeScript is going to come alongside you and enforce that, hey, this is a string, and this is a number, and this is some object with these certain fields. TypeScript is going to add those guarantees so that you can code with more confidence. In practice, you'll find that you'll have fewer dumb errors. If you're working on a team, it becomes vastly easier to communicate what certain code does because they can see right there what the types are, and when they go to use them, TypeScript is going to tell them if they're using them erroneously. It's easier to communicate with your future self so that when you come back to your code, it's easier to tell how things work. You can just look and see what the types of various objects are without having to go back and actually run the program to see if the guesses you're making about the program are actually true. In short, the code has become much more self-documenting. If you go to the TypeScript website, you'll see Microsoft describes TypeScript as JavaScript that scales. What exactly does that mean? What that has meant in my experience is that you can bring a team of people together, or you can work on something yourself, and you can build programs and applications that are very large and complex, and you're going to have much more confidence in what you're building and in how you're managing the complexity than you would if it was just plain JavaScript. I can recall numerous times on plain JavaScript projects before we started using TypeScript that I would go and I'd refactor something, move some code around, change some logic, or whatever, and I could never be entirely sure that I hadn't broken something. Even if my tests passed, even if my manual testing, everything was working right, I was never able to be fully confident in the changes I had made. It seems like there's always something that flew under the radar and got missed. With TypeScript, that happens far, far less often. In fact, I'd say almost never. TypeScript is a strict superset of JavaScript. What that means is that anything you know about JavaScript can transfer into your knowledge of TypeScript. There's definitely new things to learn, but it's not like a whole new world that you'll be completely lost and confused in. If you already know JavaScript, you'll be good to go. In a lot of cases, you can take code that you've already written in JavaScript, change the file extension from .js to .ts, and everything will work, or most of it will work with maybe a few extra type annotations that you'll need to add in. So it's very straightforward to get started and to jump in. Another great thing about TypeScript is that it compiles directly to JavaScript. In practice, this means you don't have to install any extra runtime or ship any additional library to your users in order to start using TypeScript in your application. In development, you'll just run the TypeScript compiler and then away you go. Since it's just plain JavaScript, you can use the same debugging tools that you're already used to. You can also gradually introduce TypeScript into an existing JavaScript project by just slowly converting files to TypeScript bit by bit as you go along. If you've used other languages that compile to JavaScript, you might be used to the compiled code looking unintelligible, very much like a machine wrote it. In most cases, TypeScript is merely erasing your type annotations so that your original code remains. In cases where it does have to manipulate things, I've found it makes very readable choices about the code it produces. Another great thing about TypeScript too is that it supports many of the new features that have been added to JavaScript in ES6 and other newer JavaScript versions. Not only that, but you can have TypeScript compile to older JavaScript versions so that you can use the latest and greatest features in TypeScript, but still support older browsers. One thing I wanted to mention as well is that the types are in a lot of cases optional, or what you might call gradual, or they can be inferred by TypeScript. That means there's a lot of cases where you don't really need to tell it what the type of something is. It'll see, hey, I'm setting this variable to a string, so it must be a string, and you don't have to do redundant typings that you might have gotten used to if you came from a C# or a Java background, and that's really nice. Also, depending on the configuration flags you set and how much you use the catch-all any type, you can use the type checking as much or as little as you want. If you want it to be super strict and have types everywhere, you can. Or if you want to write JavaScript in the more dynamic, untyped way that you're used to, you totally can. I think TypeScript helps enforce some good habits in a few different ways. First, once you get used to the typings, it becomes very natural when writing new code to sketch out the interfaces and the relationship between data before you start writing code, because you can use those right away when you actually start implementing your program, rather than just leaving them as inert comments or notes or thoughts in your head. Second, depending on how you configure TypeScript, you can make it so it's much more strict about checking for null and undefined, which is a really good habit to get into. I've been guilty myself of getting lazy and thinking, well, this could fail as null or undefined, but I'm just going to ignore it because it makes my code a lot simpler. But if TypeScript is yelling at me, I'm much more likely to do the proper thing, and that's really good. Third, if you're defining a type and it becomes hard to think about it or hard to describe, a lot of the times that's been an indication to me that, hey, I'm making this a lot more complicated than it needs to be, or I'm trying to do this in a way that might be clever now, but it's not going to stand up to the test of time. I'm going to come back to this later and be super confused, or I'm going to have to hand this off to a coworker and they're going to be super confused. Better IDE support is one thing that's great if you're using something like Visual Studio Code or JetBrains WebStorm or any other IDE or smart text editor with TypeScript. You get way better auto-completion so that you can access things or call functions and it's going to tell you, hey, this is how you call this thing, or hey, that's an error, you missed a parameter here, and that kind of thing. If you've used just plain JavaScript in the past, you'll know that IDEs can be pretty good about guessing what things might be, but there's a lot of times where you'll start typing a piece of code, and it does the auto-completion, and it gives you every possible field name that I've defined in my project as an option, which is extremely unhelpful. With TypeScript, you avoid that issue entirely. It knows what the types of things are, and so you get vastly better auto-completion support, which makes you a much happier and productive programmer. So that's a general overview of what TypeScript is. I hope that was helpful to you. I've got other videos out there on TypeScript, so if you want to learn more, please check them out. If you visit typescriptbyexample.com, you'll see some of the info on a course that I'm building for TypeScript. You can put your email address in at the bottom of the page, and you'll be notified when it's ready. I'd love to hear from you, and I'd love to have you be a part of the course. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.